cool. We've been sitting long enough. It's time to dance. Find a partner. We're going to start with what's known as proper contour lines.
All right, so Dottie Welch from Halifax, Nova Scotia.
All right, find a partner. If it happens to be a man and a woman, put the lady on my left side and the gentleman on my right and line up in these lines that they're making here.
I just had to make sure. Yeah, I was waiting.
Anybody else? All right. So this session is titled Ideas from Traditional Dances. Now, you've already kind of had a bit of an experience with Virginia Reel a couple of times this time. So this is what I would consider the simplest version that I do of things that have been stolen from the Virginia Reel, if you like. So, basically, we've got these contour lines, and I'm going to ask you to join hands down the man's line, down the lady's line, and around the end, making a very long, very skinny circle. And you're going to circle to the left, everybody together, and you're going to go for 16 steps. After you've gone 16, turn and come back the other way. And you'll know when you're back where you belong. Now it's getting like an orange instead of like a skinny circle. Yes. Okay.
Squeeze the orange.
Yes, squeeze the orange, exactly. You'll know when you're back when you're facing your partner again. All right. You're going to reach out with your left arm and turn your partner by the left arm. Right up close so that there's... Yep. And then turn your partner by the right arm. The long lines reach out and go forward and back. And the couple at the top, either sachet or strut to the foot, whatever's your preference, and the rug's not too good for the sachet, so just strut. Yeah. Everybody else move up a little bit, and we're going to go right into the circle. That's a skinny circle. Keep it skinny. Circle. Keep going. And the other way back. All the way back. Face your partner, turn your partner left arm.
Oh, left.
And right arm. Long line, forward and back. Top couple, strut to the foot. Go, quick, quick. And circle. There's a tendency to stop. Come the other way back. But if they're slow getting the circle going, then they have some time to actually move before you want to turn them around. Partner left arm. And partner right. Forward and back. Top couple down the center, go. Everybody circle. Keep going. And the other way back. Turn your partner left arm. Notice that's the body flow. That's why it's that arm. And right arm. Forward and back. Top couple down the middle go. Whoa. Circle. And the other way back. Turn your partner left arm. And right arm. Forward and back. Top couple. Down the center. Whoa. Circle. And circle right. Top couple down the center, go. And bow right there, okay. I'm not gonna go all the way through any of these because I wanna show you more and you've experienced that. All right, so skinny circle variation on the Virginia reel. Yeah.
Out our way, we've got two nicknames for the skinny circle.
And one some is, others too.
One is chainsaw.
Yes.
So they'll keep that. Yes, the other one is sausage.
Okay. And the third one, the one in our part of the neck of the woods, is long potato.
Oh, okay, of course.
Okay. You suggest the shape.
Yeah. But man, I like to talk about, you know, long potato and turning into an orange and okay. So that's obviously pretty simple teach, pretty quick start for something. A lot of you probably seen over time the No Name Contra that Jerry Helt wrote. And this uses more from the original Virginia reel, but it has a variation on it. So in this case, everybody's going to go forward and back. I'm going to do that two times. Do it again. Turn your partner right hand round. Yes. Turn your partner left hand round. And the top couple strut or go down in the center to the foot. Go ahead. When you get down there, you're going to come, make an arch, single-handed arch, and you're going to come up over the line of ladies. Up over the line of ladies. All the way. And then down over the line of men. And stay at the foot with a lady on her side and the gentleman on his side. That's it. All right. So, and if there's time, that the choreography says everybody swing, but with as many as we've got, you're probably not going to have time to do that. So let me just change the music. This is in Dancing for Busy People. The original music listed is either Love in the Country or Showboat or Dashing White Sergeant. So this is Love in the Country. And just a second, it's too fast for this application. Here we go. Forward and back. Forward again. Partner, right hand around. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Come back. Top couple down the middle. Arch over the ladies. Okay, here they come. Down over the men. Duck eyes. Everybody ready? Forward go. Forward again. Turn your partner right hand. Left hand. Top couple down the center. It always makes things difficult. Up over the ladies. And down over the gentleman. One more. Forward go. Forward again. Turn your partner by the right. Left hand. Top couple down the middle. Up over the ladies. And down over the gents. Everybody up to the middle. And bow right there. Now this one,
Dottie,
yeah?
May I make a suggestion?
Mm-hmm.
If you have a contra line
and you're doing a program that you're not familiar with, some church group or whatever. At the end of the contra, or your pattern, have the men change places with the girls. That way, when you have the last of the men come up or the ladies come up on the wrong side, you know you've done everybody.
Good point. Mm-hmm. Very good point. Otherwise, you have to do that mental who was first to keep it in your head. Okay. Good point. Okay. All right, so this one, there's a set of community dance resource books out there written by a lady named Marion Rose when she was writing when she was living in British Columbia. One of the dances she has in there is this one, and it's called, I'm not even sure exactly how you pronounce it, Kaimarusa. And what it actually says in the book about this is that it's a South American folk dance that appears to have, is listed in a Brownie or Guide activity book published in 1976. And it's described, as I say, in her book. The tale that goes with it is that apparently some child was welcomed back to her home somewhere in South America, and they did this dance, and hence it got into the vocabulary. And the interesting thing about it is that you will recognize this figure. So, top couple, improvise dance steps down the center. As you've been doing, you're good at that. I see this. And come on back. Come up the middle, up the middle, up the middle.
Now she tells us.
Up the middle, come on back, up the middle. He's really improvising. Okay, you only have 16 counts to achieve all of this. Then you're going to separate and lead your own line down the outside. And make an arch. And come on through. Does this sound familiar? So, do you know which part of Virginia Reel we've stolen this one from? So, and this is the music. It's kind of one of those singing things. I won't pretend that I've learned this, because this is not something I've used very many times, but here we go. She sings. Top couple, down middle. Come on back. Should be used up more than your time. Separate and lead them. Should be back at the top of this, we're right. Down the middle, look out, they're coming. Come on back. Ah, there we go. Couple down. Come back. Here we go. Top couple, go. And separate. Top couple, go. And back. Separate. Down. Come on back. Separate. And bow. that's it. Bow, right there. We're done. All right. So that's three. Now, I also have in the handout the whole Virginia Reel original version, in case anybody doesn't know what it is. I'm not going to ask you to dance it. We've already seen all the bits and pieces at some time earlier. And I also have printed the one that came from Dancing for Busy People, which is the Virginia No Reel. I'm just going to do a little bit of this one because I have yet another piece of optional music here. We've heard some others. This one is from a CD called Sound of New England. It's a contra piece of music. It's called O'Donnell Abu Medley. And so it's going to be the first part of Virginia Reel, essentially, without the trailing part. Starts with a forward and back, right hands, left hands, both hands, and then sashay down the middle and come on back, separate and lead them in. I'm only going to go through this a couple of times, so just so you get a feeling for the music. Forward and back. Turn your partner right hand round. And a left hand. And both hands. Top couple down the middle. Go. Turn and come on back. Separate and lead them. Same thing as the last time. Be quick. Right hand round, left hand round, both hands round, top couple down the middle, go, turn and come on back, separate and lead them. You can see that if you have more than six, and even six is pushing your lock to get them all through the arch, you have to adjust your time. All right. So that's our samples from the Virginia Reel. And there's a handout that you can all pick up when you get now. You'll notice that I'm going from the back to the front because when I got it printed, I was trying to squeeze everything in, and so that's where it ended up. So, okay. Now I would like to go to squares, which is, make me some squares here, a couple of squares. You can do this. Yep, you're fine. You'll be there. You'll be okay. Super. No. Well, does she need to sit?
Yeah, she needs to sit.
Okay. Can we need another dancer then? All right, so the first one we're going to do is a traditional square dance called Lady Round the Lady. I'm going to show you the original and then briefly describe a possible variation that's a more modern application that you could use with a scene call if you wanted to. So the directions say, first of all, couple number one, back to me. Couple number two, on my right. Couple number three, facing me. And couple number four. Now remember your number. It's going to stay your number all the way through the dance. Okay. So, couple number one, the lady is going to lead the gentleman, her partner, between couple number two. And the call it will be, just hold it when you get there, you can start in between. The lady is going to go, let go of each other. The lady is going to go to her left around the lady, and the gent's going to go to his right around the gent. And then come on around back in again. She's going to lead between again, but this time she's going to go around the gent, and he's going to go around the lady. The end of that, turn and face the people that you're with there. And that group of four is going to circle a little bit more than halfway around. Go ahead, circle. Center's arch and dive through, so not quite three quarters because you don't want to run into somebody. Now, that the original figure says both of those couples then swing. So both those two, just the two active couples, and then couple one, you're going to do the same figure with the ones on the outside there, number three. So lady around the lady, and the gent go around the gent, and the lady will lead again, around the gent and the gent around the lady, circle, half, and a little smidgen, and dive through, and both couples swing. Notice the swing helps that in the number three couple get themselves back where they belong, and the, one more time, lady around the lady, and the gent around the gent, and the lady around the gent, and the gent around the lady, and both circle, dive, swing, and then the whole thing repeats for couple number two doing the same kind of action. Okay, so I'm going to, since the first ones have already done this, I'm going to let couple number two have a go with some music. And the music that I'm using is Silver Bells. It's on old timer. I haven't searched, and I'm doubtful that you can get it, but it's not unique to this. It's my favorite piece for using for traditional dancing. I'm sure you can find something that'll work for you. Couple number two, the lady lead between number three, round the lady, gent round the gent. Lady between, lady round the gent, and gent around the lady, join your hands, circle left. Center's arch, dive through, both couples swing. Lady two, lead between, round the lady, gent round the gent, lady between. Feet some circle. Center's arch, dive three, both couples swing. Lady lead, lady round the lady, gent round the gent. Lady between, round the gent, gent round the lady. Circle, center's arch, dive three, both couples swing. Couple three, lead to the right, lady round the lady, and the gent around the gent, lady round the gent, gent round the lady. Circle half, center's arch, dive through, and both couples swing. Lady between, round the lady, and gent round the gent. She goes round and he goes round, she join your hands, circle left. Dive through and both couples swing. Lady lead between, around the lady, gent round. One more. Circle out. Dive through, both couples swing. Couple four, your turn. The lady lead around the lady, and the gent go around the gent. Lady between, round the gent, gent go around the lady. Join your hands and circle to the left. Center's arch, dive through, both couples swing. And the lady lead around that lady, gent around the gent. Other way. Circle. Both couples swing. Lady lead between, one more. Join and circle up. Dive through, everybody swing. A little music, join your hands, circle left. This is where you wing it. Circle right, the other way back. Up to the middle and come on back. Everybody swing your partner. And bow to your partner, corner two. All right. Now, the alternative version that you can use if you want to think modern would be to have both head ladies lead to the right simultaneously. So let's just walk this. Head ladies each lead their partner to the right and go between the couple there. Yep. Lady around the lady, and the gent go around the gent, and then the lady go around the gent, and the gent go around the lady. Circle four. Now, this time, go once. And an extra quarter more so that you're in lines. Okay? The side couples, the original side couples arch, and the other ones dive through, and everybody swing your own and promenade. Yeah, I don't, did all of you go? Yeah, I think you're okay. Yeah, I don't think you went for, yeah, I think, yeah. Yeah, I don't think you went the once and a quarter. Yeah, you went three quarters, and that's why you're out of sequence, yeah. All right, so that's, but you can put that to singing call music of your choice. So that's something else you can do it. All right, now this one, I see that it was on Paul's Moore's handout as well, but he didn't talk about it particularly, and it's called The Grapevine Twist. Okay, how many have done The Grapevine Twist? Do I have some people that know the pattern? All right, so Chris knows the pattern, so I'm going to let you kind of show it, because otherwise I have to get out there and show somebody. So I'll describe. So what's going to happen here, or actually, it's the man that needs, sorry, in this case it's the man, so you can cheat.
Do whatever you say.
Yeah, you can kind of push. Okay, so man number two is going to lead between taking his partner with him. So take your lady by the wrist. You're going to go around the lady, and the lady goes with him. Come back in. Now, as you come back in, the original figure has a figure eight loop. Yeah, so you come right around and then go back through the same opening and around the gent. And all four of those join hands in a circle. Circle once around until that active man is able to then lead on between with the same figure and to keep with him. So now we've got four dancers. All right. Do that loop. So you're going to loop around to your right, loop around to your right. All the way. That's it. So that's the figure eight part of it. And then keep going. Yes. And join hands with these people in circle six. And go on around until he can lead between, same figure again. So right around, do the big loop. And in between again, and on around. And then you can, I'll just pull it out. You could do a circle, but I'll just tell you stop where you are, because you're right there. All right, so let's have couple number one in both squares have a chance to go with this. So the call is actually, first, gent, take your lady by the wrist. And this is one of those old traditional calls. There's a lot of words here. I know I won't get them all out of my mouth at just the right time because there's too many. But first, gent, take your lady by the wrist. Gent, lead right for a grapevine twist. Go around that lady fair into the center and loop to your right, right there. Now, lead around the gent. You're doing fine. Join hands and circle in time. Same gent, lead all four onto the next and repeat the twist and don't get vexed. Go around the next lady fair into the center and loop right there. Now lead around the gent, join six hands and circle in time. Same gent, lead on all six to the next, the last, repeat the twist and keep moving fast. Yeah, round that last lady, into the center, and loop, and a lead round the gent you did not see. Join eight hands, and circle around for me. Okay, and you can keep circling a little bit this time. Then swing your partners up and down, swing the girl in the calico gown, and everybody promenade. Okay. The music that's listed for use for this is Turkey in the Straw. So. Here we go.
You're going to start with number two?
Yeah. No, I think I'm going to start with number three. Okay? Start with number three. Number three, take your lady by the wrist, lead round for a grapevine twist, round the lady into the center, and loop around the gent, doing fine, join hands and circle in time. Same gent, lead all four, on to the next, repeat the twist and don't get vexed. Around the lady, into the center, and loop right there, now lead round the gent. Join six hands and circle around. Same gent, lead on to the last. Repeat the twist, moving fast. Around the lady, into the middle, and loop. And between again, and around the gent. Join eight hands and circle around you go. 4. First jam, take your lady by the wrist for a great banquet. Grab the jam, tick up 4, circle. Same gentle lead between number 2 and that lady right there. The loop in the center. And circle 6. Sing gently around the lady. Into the middle and loop them. Everybody circle. Partner and promenade you right there. All right, good. Let's stop right there. So there's a fancy ending, and I looked at this up on the internet. There's a fancy ending for this. I'm going to let you see if you can figure it out. And if you can't figure it out, go to YouTube and look at it. All right, one more here. And then I got 2 more things, but I did start late, and I know we have a discussion time following, so I'm going to sneak a little time here. All right. This one, it was actually presented by Ron Counts quite a few years back at one of these events, and I thought it was neat, and my dancers think it's wonderful. They keep asking for this. So this is a big favor. And he did one version. I actually got on the internet. I had some discussion with David Milhouse over the email with regard to what should be going on the history of square dance site, because he was working on this one. And they came up with, they were trying to figure out who wrote this to begin with, which is not easy. We know it goes back to a document that was written in 1953 by a man named Wes McVicker, and it's with 75 more square dances that came out of Toronto, Canada. We do not know whether he wrote it or whether he got it from somebody else. We do know that there is a slightly earlier document, which was the preceding version, because this is a 75 more. I have the documents, the preceding version. It's definitely not in that one. So that's as far back as we know, and there's 2 slightly different versions here. So first couple, balance and swing. And go down the center and split the ring. The lady go right, and the gent go left, and go around and stand behind, whoa, don't go any further than that, stand behind the person of the same gender as you on the side. Okay, so you go around one and stand behind the next one. All right, gently push those people into the middle, and they will swing in the center, and you're only if you're pushed, and then you back away at the vacant location. Okay, now, where is Mr. Number 1? Okay, you're the key in this for the moment. So the same gent, take wherever you are, take the new lady down the center and split 2 and around 1 and stand behind the next and push them into the middle and swing. Push all ma and push all pa, yes. Back out in the vacant spot, and where's man number 1? Down the center, split them. Lady go right, and the gent go left, round 1, stand behind the next, push them in, and swing in the middle, and back out. And now, okay, all you people that are thinking, we have to do this 4 times, look what you've got. A miracle has occurred, right? You're all back with your partner, so you only don't have to do it 4 times, you only have to do it 3 times. Okay, now, but you have moved, because where's man number 1? He's now in the number 2 position. So the dance continues with man number 2 doing it, and then man number 3, and man number 4. And at the end of all of that, you will be back home. So I'm going to proceed from here with man number 2. Original man number 2, yes. Figure out who he is and make sure you know. Now, the music that this one lists, the music is Doc Boyd's jig, and if you look carefully at the Lloyd Shaw information, the record that Lloyd Shaw labels as Come and See Me, the music is Dr. Boyd's jig. So, here it is. So, man number 2, balance and swing. Down the center and split the ring. The lady go right and the gent go left, around and push him in. Swing. And back out. Man number two, again, down the middle. Split the ring. Lady go left, right and the gent go left, push him in. And swing. And back it up. Gent number two, here we go again. And push him in. And swing. And back it out. Everybody has their partner, so it's number three's turn. Where's number three? Down the center go. Lady go right, the gent go left. Push all ma and push all ba. Swing in the middle and back it up. Gent number three again, down the center, split the ring. And around one, push him in. And back him up. And gent number three again, down the middle. Split, push. And we have one more couple, because we're all back with our partner. Gent number four, where are you? Down the middle, here we go. Split the ring, around one. Push him in and swing. Back it up. Gent number four, go. Push him in and back it up. Gent number four again, down the middle. Split the ring. Push and swing. And circle left. Everybody up to the middle and come on back. Face your partner, swing. And promenade around you go. All right, here, let's stop right there. Now, that version's the one that's listed on the History of Square Dance. This is the version that Ron Counts taught us. And instead of tracking the man, it essentially tracks the lady. All right, so let's try this again. So, first couple across and split the ring, exactly like you did the first time. Separate around one, push them in, and they swing and back out. But now, where is the lady, the active lady gone? She's now in couple number two. So, lady and or couple number two go down the middle and split the ring. And separate and push them in. And now she's in couple number three. So couple number three come down the middle and split the ring and push them in and swing. And I think you could do the same thing, but in this case, the way he did it, everybody circled to the left until you're home again. So that's going to be a three-quarter circle to get yourself home again. And whatever other filler you want to add in there to make it the timing come out right. Okay, and then it repeats for lady couple number two, and they are essentially, so it would be couple two, and then three, and then four, and then it would be three, and she's going to be three, four, and one, and then four is going to be, okay, so interesting variation on the pattern, and that one times out, if you do this circle, you'll find that it times out perfectly to 64 beats. So that's a very useful piece of information, whereas the other dance, because you're holding it, and it comes out kind of an odd number of eights, it would be a little bit trickier to melody your music. All right, questions so far? Let us go to a big circle. I have one more group, and this is kind of typical ending kind of thing, so perhaps appropriate for this. So in the contra world particularly, they nearly always end the evening with a circle waltz. All right? And the old traditional circle waltz is the bingo waltz. So this is the bingo waltz, original version. This is off Lloyd Shaw. Remember, we're thinking in threes now because this is a waltz. And in fact, because it is kind of a country style waltz, the balance in and balance out, which could be one, two, three, back, two, three, can also be achieved by just balance in, balance back. So if you want to run your energy off, then one, two, three, back, two, three. And if you don't feel so energetic, just step in and step out on the balance. So balance in, and balance out. And then we're going to have the girls roll away in six steps to get over there. Balance in and out. And roll her away. Balance in and out. And roll her away. That's the third time. And balance in and out. And roll her away. For a total of four times. And face the new partner coming to you and join both hands. Using your inside foot, we're going to do a, what sometimes called as a slide in, or more technically, a side draw and change weight, and then a side touch. Going to the middle, so ladies right and gents left, slide in, then go out, slide out, do it again, slide in, slide out, and here's where the bingo part comes from. We're going to do a grand right and left, and you're going to say B, go B, I, N, G, and swing with O. And face into the middle, and here we go. Original music, bingo waltz. Balance in. Roll away. Balance in. Roll away. Balance in. Roll away. Balance in. Roll away and face this new partner. Slide in. Slide out. Do it again. Grand right and left. B, I, N, G, O. And balance in. Roll away. Again. Roll away. Again. Roll. One more. Face the new partner. Slide in. Slide out. Again. Grand right and left. Go B. I. N. G. Looks like a good place to stop. Okay. Now, didn't stop. There we go. Okay, so we have a couple of other versions of this. One version is simply to do the same deal, the balance in, balance out, roll away, four times, side draw in, side draw out, and then so in this place, face your partner. So you're doing the slide draw in and the slide draw out. So do that part. So slide draw in, slide draw out. Now, you could do, so this is a no partner change variation. You're going to step into banjo position with your partner. So that's right hip to right hip. And just go, what some people refer to as tippy toe or waltz, essentially. So you've got four measures of waltz. Go one, two, three. Two, two, three, three, two, three, and reverse to sidecar and come back. One, two, three, two, two, three, three, two, three, and face in, and the whole thing would start again. So there's less partner change. You change on the rollaways, but you don't change on the at that last point. Okay. Another version is simply to let them freestyle waltz during those same beats of music. And I have one more that I'm going to do for you. This is slightly different variation. So this one has the balance in and out and roll away. And we only do that twice. This is a short version. Okay, face your partner, do the slide in. So slide in, slide in, slide out, slide out. And then we're going to weave by three people, and so it's three beats per each person. So weave by three, go one, two, three, and in the last three beats, turn and face in, ready to start again. And this is Pally Breezes I'm using. It's an old round dance on Belco. Here we go. Face your new partner, slide in. Slide out. We by three. Face in, balance in. Roll away again. Roll away. Face up. Slide in. Slide out. And we by three. Face in, balance, roll away, balance, roll away, face a new partner, slide in, slide out, we by three. Face in and slide in, slide out, we by three, face in and out. That's the end of my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it. There are handouts up here.
All right.
Very nice. Thank you, Dottie.
Very good, Dottie. Thank you. All right. Pick up. There are handouts from this session down here on the table. They're over by the door. There are handouts from the previous sessions, the ones that we have.
Interesting. Anybody down here? Amplifier.
Well, we've set up to come to bass section. Here's the treble.
Oh, that's the bass section?
Yeah, this is the bass.
Okay,
and treble is up here.
Yeah, and is it bold to take out this assembly?
It's a Bose L1.
It's too hard. Weigh a ton? It doesn't look
no,
like it.
You're going to be immediate.
So, just a couple of comments while we're thinking about this. There was a comment about the roll away. One of the things about a roll away is that in the days when most of these dances were written, roll away was called roll away with a half sachet, with a half sachet. The gentleman, the roll-away was the lady's part, and the half-sachet was the men moving across into their spot. So there was a roll-away actually is a two-part, with a half-sachet is a two-part figure in the way this was originally written and originally danced. So if you think about a roll-away, if you are rolling the lady from here to here, the men don't move, all right? An original thinking of this was roll away while the men were doing a half sachet, and that's the reason why it went to roll away, was a roll away with a half sachet. In today's world, in our definitions, a roll away has become both of those. So in today's world, a roll away is the man moving over while the lady is rolling across if it's done in a static square. So roll away with a half sachet in old terminology has the same meaning and definition as roll away does in our current definitions that are written for square dancing. So being aware of that. If you're circling and you hear roll away, gentlemen, you aren't moving back, but you are stopping while the lady is rolling across and then continuing the circling. So there's some variations in the way you think about it. And if you do roll away from a static square, the gents need to move. In the original definition, a roll away was just that. It was move the lady from this side to this side. That's the original roll away. A rollaway with a half sash A in the original definition was rolling her into the spot as you moved. If you listen to some of the folks that are saying, if you say roll away with a half sash A, they're saying it's two calls. They're saying it's this and this. If you call roll away with a half sash A today, it's actually two. So there's ambiguity in our presentation, in our current terminology.